Hello there. Greetings from DL's workshop. Well, let's get to the point. We've seen so many comments below our real FNAF videos, where you asked us to assemble a kind of tutorial on building a real animatronic robot. So, you asked it, you got it. In this video we're gonna build a simple animatronic character along with you, showing you all the work process, and explaining every detail, and trying to make this journey as interesting and entertaining as it possible. Let's go! In this video we're going to build a simple prototype animatronic doll, which will be able to move around and perform basic gestures and movements. You can study robotics a bit deeper and create more complicated characters, but the purpose of this tutorial is to show the very basics. Yes, this is something like a detailed instruction for very beginners. First of all, you need to create a moving endoskeleton for your robot. There are two ways to make your animatronic move: hydraulics, pneumatics and servos. In this video we'll be using servos, since it's much cheaper and easier in some ways. Servo is a gear motor which can be programmed to rotate by a certain degree measure. You can use servos to move robots' arms, eyes, eyelids, head or even to make your creation roll around. Any electronic device must receive power. Otherwise, it won't work at all. To power any device there are two poles used. Batteries are used as a mobile power source. For our project I recommend using a 6V battery. And at least 3A. Servo has three wires, two of them should be connected to any sort of power supply, while the third one is used to control the rotation of the servo. To control it we'll be using Arduino. Arduino is an open source controller board, and it's easy to write a code for a few servos. You have to purchase a board itself, and download Arduino IDE for your PC, so you will be able to program your character. Let's assemble our first circuit and load a first program. This code makes your servo to rotate from the 90° position to 180° and back. You can add more servos to the program's code. If you want to make your motor go smooth, we recommend using 4 operator. Here's the code which rotates servos the same way, but they run much smoother. If you need several servos run at the same time, you can add a few of them into the loop. Congratulations! Now you have a functional servo system for your animatronic. You can write any type of code and add more servos to make your robot perform any movements. Now we need to build the robot itself. Now we have to create a skeleton for the robot and make pre-programmed servos move its arms, body, head and legs. The bones of our skeleton will be made out of plastic tubing. It should be light and durable enough at the same time. While you are assembling the robot's arm, you can fix the servo's shafts directly to the rotating parts. We know that a similar connection method is not accepted recommended, but our experience says that it's fine for this kind of robots. As for head and body, you can use the same way of making the parts move, but when it comes to the heavier stuff, that's when the bearing can make everything much more reliable. To fix the servo in the skeleton, we usually carve a special block out of wood, where the rotating mechs will be fixed. This is how it looks. Here you have it. Now it's time to build the legs for the robot. Some creators tend to fix the characters on the kind of tripod or stand, but for our project, it would be better to put two wooden planks instead of legs. Don't worry, we'll get back to that once more a bit later. It's extremely difficult to make robot walk, so we use wheels for all our robots. Let's see how to build this kind of wheeled platform. This time you just have to make two rotating mechs and put them together, adding wheels. This time though, we do not recommend putting servos inside, since it will be quite difficult to control the wheels. You can use simple geared DC motors, or still use servos, but you'll have to provisionally disassemble it, and remove variable resistor as well as the circuit board, and then connect two wires directly to the motor's terminals. To control the motors by program, you can use any sort of drivers or shields. Then we just need to fix our character on the platform. Now it's time to make a suit for the animatronic. We always use Penaplex polyfoam to make the shells, but we're not sure if it's sold in your country, so you can use any other type of hard foam. You need to place all the parts on the sheet, then carve it and put together. To make the suit not blocky, you can cut the sharp angles using knife, and then process it with a sandpaper or a rasp grater. Here you go. Now you just left to paint the suit. To give it an abandoned and rusty look, we recommend paint a layer of any color, and then apply the main color less carefully. Now you just need to put the suit on the endo, and fasten it. Note, you can add a few additional servos to the leg parts and program them to move, while the robot will be rolling around on its wheels. This will look like the character is actually walking. Congratulations! Now you have your own animatronic character which can entertain you and your friends. You can complicate the robot by connecting and programming sensors, so the machine will be able to perceive and be aware of its environment. You can add any kind of MP3 players and speakers, so the robot could talk and sing. But we'll get to all this next time. Thanks for watching and welcome to the magnificent world of robotics and engineering.